ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜியர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் சத்சங்கம், ஹவு டு டெவலப் த சத்சங்கம். சத்சங்கம் இஸ் அ வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஆஸ்பெக்ட் ஃபார் ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவர். வாட் இஸ் சத்சங்கம்? சத்சங்கம் இஸ் அ கேதரிங். Sangam means gathering. Sat here indicates Sat Vishayam, any matters relating to Bhagavan, Alvars, Acharyas and so on. So that is one way of looking at Satsangam, a gathering to discuss Bhagavad Vishayam. Another way to look at it is Sat indicates the people who are part of that gathering, sadhus. Sadhu means generally we have an idea, very soft spoken or very gentle. That is the normal picture we have about a sadhu, or even saintly person in a general way. But if we look at Gita Bhashyam, Bhagavad Ramanuja explains the word sadhu very elaborately and very beautifully. In the shlokam, in the very well-known shlokam, Paritranaya sadhunam, vinashaya cha dushkritam, dharma samsthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Krishna says that he incarnates again and again. Whenever the dharma goes down, I take birth, I re-establish dharma, I protect the sadhus and I annihilate the miscreants or the evil people. So in this particular shlokam, for the word sadhu, Bhagavad Ramanuja beautifully and elaborately explains that sadhu is someone who abides by shastram to start with. He is topmost of Vaishnavas, Vaishnava Agresharaha. He has so much craving to reach Bhagavan. He has so much attachment towards Bhagavan. He is most knowledgeable. And so on. In this manner he explains in great detail who a sadhu is. So this satsangam is supposed to be the gathering of such noble people. Even though we may not be as noble as explained in Gita Bhashyam by Bhagavad Ramanuja, our aspirations should be like that. We should see our alvars, our acharyas, how they lived, what kind of dignified and noble life they had, and we should aspire for such life. So such gathering of noble people can also be said as satsangam. In either case, when there is noble subject, the people who are involved will aspire to be noble or will be noble. And when the people are noble or when they aspire for such noble state, then the discussion will also be in line with that, will be in relation to Bhagavan and Alvars and Acharyas. So this satsangam is required for our own benefit, for our own improvement in our spiritual progress. And it is also required to develop a community around us. Now this satsangam could be physical. Ideally it should be physical. In the olden days we all know that there are many Dividesams, Abhimanasthalams, Alvaracharya, Avatarasthalams, and so many sacred holy abodes of Bhagavan. In every town, in every village, there will always be satsangams at the temple, at the homes, at the mutts, at the Acharya and Tirumaligais. In every possible place, there will be satsangam. And discussions will be centered upon Bhagavan, Alvars and Acharyas, their works, Shastram, Vedam, and then Tamil Prabandhams, and so on. But as things have progressed, as people started going away from the Videshams and their native towns, the distances have become larger between people. So at times we also need satsangam in using technology in online manner. So satsangam is both at a physical level and at a virtual level. So even though we may be distance apart, we may be staying in two different places, by connecting virtually, we can feel the presence, we can discuss Bhagavad Vishayam as if we are discussing face to face. We can use the technology and we can do all of that. So the satsangam can happen at various modes. It should happen in physical mode, and it can also happen in virtual mode. So we have to see all of those possibilities. Some of the aspects relating to satsangam, which we all need to think about, we all need to explore. Satsangam has been happening for ages, as we all know, and even using technology for many years by now, people are using the technology in several ways to connect all over the world and have satsangams. So there are some proven methodologies, and there are some well-established norms and well-established practices which have worked for people. So we can try to follow those examples. If we look at history, if we look into the history, we see that satsangams start very small. Because oftentimes we always think that we need many people to have a satsangam. But really we only need two persons for a satsangam. If there are two persons, then a satsangam can happen. There is bodhayanta parasparam. There is discussion about Bhagavan. One person shares, another person listens, and then another person shares, another person, the first person listens, and so on. So just two persons are sufficient for satsangam. And if we look at, into the past in history, we can see that all great institutions, all great sampradayams, they all started with just few people. If you look at our own sampradayam, in the times of Nammalvar, there was only Madhurakavi Alvar who was serving Nammalvar in a full dedicated way. There were others in Alvar Thirunagari who were coming and having darshan of Alvar and probably praising him, but it was only Madhurakavi Alvar who was fully committed and fully surrendered to Alvar, and who was being guided by Alvar. And subsequently, it took several years for the sampradayam to reach the masses, thousands of years. From Nammalvar to Nathamunigal, if we see, there is about 4000 years gap. And it was by the grace of Nammalvar, Nathamunigal got all the Divya Prabandhams and the meanings and so on. And even then it was not growing at a rapid pace. The sampradaya was growing at a gradual pace. But during the advent, after the advent of Bhagavad Ramanuja, things started changing. And even in Embarumanar Ramanuja's situation, if we see, he started with just Kurathalvan and Mudaliyandan. They were the only two disciples who were with Ramanuja. But eventually, as we have seen now, it has grown huge. Our sampradayam has become very big because of committed efforts from our acharyas, our advars. They have all given their 100%, more than 100%, their heart and soul in bringing out all the necessary information to the forefront and for the benefit of all of humanity, all of us. So the satsangam will always start small. It will take some time to grow. And with the presence of very noble personalities, it may take, it may acquire rapid pace and it may grow, but it is not guaranteed always on when it will happen and who will drive it and so on. So as far as we are concerned, we have to look at satsangam in this manner. We need to be together and to be discussing about Bhagavan, Advars, Acharyas, their works and all of that all the time. And for that we have to see what is the best way to do it. If we are able to go to a nearby temple, nearby mutt, Acharya Thirumaligai, where there is good satsangam, we participate in that. If we are able to connect to Bhagavatas across the world, then we should try to do that. In this manner, we should constantly be engaging in satsangam to remind ourselves of all the important principles of our sampradayam, to remind ourselves of the wonderful anubhavams from Advars, Acharya's works and so on. So this is a brief introduction about satsangam and how it can grow and all of that. There are some aspects we need to think about in developing a satsangam. I have made a small list of aspects. We'll just go through that, and in the end, you know, everyone can share their thoughts as well. First, we need people. Without people, there is not going to be satsangam. So Bhagavatas are the essential primary participants. They are needed for any satsangam. Now, as Adyan was saying, it could start with just two members. It could even be just one member with the grantham, Purvacharya granthams and Advaracharya's works. We can just engage in satsangam with the acharyas through their literature, through their granthams. But if there is at least one more person, there is more inspiration, there is more to share and discuss and evolve ourselves. So at least two persons are required for satsangam, but it should grow over time. We should attract more people into the group with similar intentions, with similar objectives, so that similarity, like-mindedness and similarity in thought process is very important for a satsangam. So this people is very important. We need some, at least some members who have some leadership qualities, some spearheading attitude. So we need some who can push others. For a good leader, the most important criteria is to be a good follower. One should have learned from acharyas, elders, Purvacharya granthams, so that we always stay in the proper line and wavelength of our Purvacharyas. We shouldn't ever be deviating from the main principles, the core principles of our Sampradayam. So, we need to have grasped things from our Acharyas, and we need a few who can drive the satsangam. This sharing and caring is very, very important, because if one person takes all the responsibility and is always doing the tasks, managing the satsangam, organizing the satsangam and so on, it puts a little bit of a vulnerability in the satsangam, because if that person is absent due to some reason or the other, then things are going to come to standstill. And it may also lead to that person developing a little bit of pride or arrogance, or that important, I am the important, I am the primary person concept. So that could happen. So for that, if there is distribution of that leadership task, then it will withstand in the long run. The next aspect is having clear goals and focus. So any satsangam, we need clear goal. Obviously, the Bhagavad Anubhavam and the Purvacharya Granthams are the main component, and studying them and understanding them and reciting pasurams, all of these make part of the main goals of a satsangam. On top of these, there will also be specific aspect for each group, each satsangam. For example, if there is a particular satsangam focused on learning Purvacharya Granthams, there may be a granth, there may be a group which is focused on just pasuram recitals. So that is the primary objective. So there is a primary objective and there is additional and common objectives. So those goals should be clear for everyone. For example, we have this Vidyapitam group. Now the purpose is to bring all the Vanamamalai Math Sishyas together overseas and help them engage in our Pathshala activities, because this is for our future generation. It is not only going to benefit Vanamamalai Math Sishyas but also all Sri Vaishnavas in general. So this Pathshala needs to grow and needs to be supported by all of us. So that is one of the primary objectives of this particular group. So for each group there will be such objectives. For example, a group may have important objective of supporting temples and utsavams where things are not happening. So that may be a particular group, and there will be a primary objective of supporting temples and utsavams and so on. So these goals, what is primary goal, what is the common goal, all of that should be clear for everyone. The next point is there should be regular engagement, and there should be regular engagement for everyone in the satsangam. It is not that just one person is always engaged in something, the others are just coming and going. That will also not be very healthy for the satsangam. So each member of the satsangam should take up some responsibility, should volunteer for some kaikaryams, and there should be collective participation and collective involvement. That will ensure that there is the cohesiveness, there is group thought process, it's not just an individual, it's a group, and there is some kaikaryam for each one of us, and we have to fulfill that kaikaryam. So that push will be there in each individual if there is shared responsibility and shared engagement for everyone. And it should also be inclusive. The concept of elite group and exclusive aspects, like only this person should do this, only that person should do that. Yes, there will be specific capabilities for individuals, and depending upon each individual's capability, one may participate in particular activities. But in overall, if you look at it, everyone should be welcomed and everyone should be accommodated and everyone should be given some responsibility, and it should even be in a rotational basis. If one person is taking care of one particular task this month, maybe the next month somebody else should take care of that particular task. So all of this is for a satsangam which is very active and which is very routinely engaging everyone. So these aspects are quite important. And there should be regular routines as well. Like for example, if we have a satsangam, it should be fixed. It should be on a particular date. Maybe it is Sunday, or maybe it's like what we are doing, the Sunday after Punarpoosam, or every Sunday, or every Ekadashi, or whatever. So that routine should be fixed in everyone's mind, and everyone should be ready for that particular time to be fully given for this particular satsangam. Next aspect is having resources. Resources and infrastructure is also very important. For example, if we are having Divya Prabandham Seva Kalam, then everyone should have the material in hand. Whatever is required for the recital, everyone should be ready for that. And somebody should take care of that particular aspect, or preparing the material for the recital for that particular day, or for that particular season, or so on. The resources is very, very important aspect. Many Sri Vaishnavas are there all over the world. They don't understand Tamil, for example. They don't read, they don't write, and they don't understand Tamil. Now, it is very important that these Sri Vaishnavas who are not having access to Tamil, they are not missing out on the important aspects. It is very, very important, because they have come with the interest and desire to become Sri Vaishnava, to learn about Bhagavan, to learn about Alvars, Acharyas, and to follow the Sampradayam. While we are accepting them, if we don't give them sufficient material, how will they practice the Sampradayam? And if we give them in a language which they don't understand, yes, it will be nice if everyone learns Tamil, if everyone learns Sanskritam, it will be very nice. But sometimes it may not be possible for everyone to learn a particular language very late in their life, due to age factor, due to memory factor, and due to so many other factors. So for such people, it is very important that we have all the resources in the language they are familiar with. Fortunately or unfortunately, English is a common language, so having a lot of our Sampradayam information in English is very, very helpful for those who have real interest in our Sampradayam, but they are not having the ability or situation to learn Tamil immediately, or even Sanskritam immediately. So resources are very, very important. If we think about, because there's a lot of even among people in our Sampradayam, we talk about Kare Karunai Ramanusa, that Embermanar gave everything to everyone so that everyone can reach Bhagavan. Even those who speak along these lines, suddenly they become very defensive about putting things out in English or other languages. Why don't they learn Tamil? Why should these Rahasya Granthams or Vyakhyanams should be given in English? Why should we put it out in public? A lot of questions come up like this. But if you look at our Sampradayam, look at our Alvars, Acharyas, if ever Alvars thought that why sing Pasurams in Tamil? Why not sing the same glories of Bhagavan in Sanskritam, which was prevailing? They could have done it. Bhagavan could have made them sing in Sanskritam itself, because all the Shastram is in Sanskritam. Itihasams, Puranams, Vedam, Agamam, everything is in Sanskritam. So Bhagavan was merciful, saying that, seeing that these people who are in the place where Tamil is being spoken, they should also understand the essence of Shastram. So it was given in Tamil. Similarly, Acharyas gave commentaries. They taught to everyone who had the desire. And those days they were writing it in palm leaves. They were making all the commentaries, they were preserving in palm leaves, which was the available mode of preservation those days. Once the printing technology came, the concept of books came, immediately many books started coming out in our Sampradayam. So technology was accepted, adapted by our elders, so that this knowledge does not get lost, because having in palm leaves and making copy of that is very, very time consuming. In those days, only one or two Tirumaligais or mutts or temples will have these granthams. Everyone has to go there, request the acharya, serve him for a long time, and then get the particular copy for reading a few days or so on. But then, when the printing press concept came, books were printed and everyone started having books. And we can appreciate, with the reduction of our abilities, memory and so on, these books have helped our Sampradayam in a great way. Puttur Swami, Kanchi Swami, they have all done so many publications, so many granthams have been worked so hard by this Chalvat Swamis. And in those days printing was not a very easy task. Proofreading and making the negative or whatever it is required for the printing press, those were all very, very time consuming and tedious process, and our elders spent so much time so that it is available for the benefit of everyone freely in a very easily accessible manner, so that this knowledge doesn't get lost. So printing is one mode of preservation. That's how we have to look at it. Similarly, once we have computers, we have cloud and mobile and technology and so on, now we are using this medium to preserve the granthams. Whatever technology is available, we are making use of it. And the point Adyen was making was, people are, even those who understand the importance of preserving, those who understand the importance of spreading this, even some of them are reluctant and hesitant towards some of these newer technology and this mode of spreading the information, spreading the Sampradayam. But we see that a lot of them will eventually take up. Those who initially hesitate, initially resist these, they will also take up at some point, understanding the value of such available tools, such tools. So these should be seen as medium and tools to preserve and carry the literature and carry the great works to next generations. So all of these resources, infrastructure, all of these are very, very important. So this is also something we need to think about when we are having satsangam. We need to make sure that we have all the resources available for everyone. Everyone should be included. Everyone should have some material which they can refer to. Because without material, if you just have satsangam, when people leave the satsangam, they forget a lot of it. Whatever was discussed in the satsangam on that particular day, by the end of the day, most of it will be forgotten. Most of it will be lost. If we have some material, if we have some books, if we have some notes, if we have some recordings, at least people can go back and recollect and refresh what was discussed. And by going through in this way, in this manner a few times, at least these principles will remain in the minds of the participants for longer duration. So it is very important to preserve, to propagate. It is one of the aspects we are lacking even now compared to many other institutions who are somewhat ahead of us in spreading the information, in preserving and passing it on to others. We are a little bit behind in having all of our Purvacharya works and simple translations and explanations and various tools to present all of this information to the next generation. So we need to think about all of these aspects. So just to summarize, we need people who are interested, who are dedicated, who are having similar thought process, like-minded people. That is the first requirement for a satsangam. We need few at least with some leadership qualities, some push. Leader doesn't mean that one who dominates and one who orders around everyone. It is just the real interest and desire to take it forward, even at adverse situations, even at very dull moments. We should be very, very motivated and focused. So such few people are required in that mode at least. We should have a common understanding about the goals and the focus. We need sharing and caring and sharing of responsibilities and regular interactions. It should be routine. It should not be haphazard. It should not be like one this month, few months later suddenly we have a satsangam and so on. It should be regular. It should be inclusive. There should be engagement for everyone. All ages should be addressed. All audience, for example, there will be people of different language background, people of different age group. Children will be there, women will be there, students will be there. Everyone's needs should be understood and they should be catered as part of satsangam. And we need the resources. We should be very, very good with resources, having the necessary, all the necessary material to conduct the satsangam. We have in our coil.org website, we have tons of material, as we all know. There is articles, translations, lectures, and so on. And even for children, we have a lot of quizzes, puzzles and games and so on. So similarly, in every satsangam, we should have our own resources. We can share. It's not that if somebody prepares a resource, it should be only by used by that particular institution or that particular group. Ideally, one should have the large heart to share everything for free and without any expectation. Only expectation is that it is being used nicely and in the way it was thought to be used. So all of these will help in developing a good satsangam. As I was saying in the beginning, it may take many years for a satsangam to become big and well settled. There will be a long process sometimes, but one should have patience and perseverance and the desire to move forward always. And with that, Adyen will stop. And if there are any thoughts, comments or questions, please feel free to ask. Alvar Embermanar, G.R. Thirudigalai Sharanam, G.R. Thirudigalai Sharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.